Okay.
Any woman who fondles me in a men's room, I think I could be on a first-name basis with. That's not fair. You told me to pull out your penis.
How about a cup of coffee?
Where is she?
Oh, boy.
Where is she?
There's nobody here.
Liar! I heard her. So you want to get married and settle down, huh?
Peggy, I swear it, there's nobody else here.
Come on out, you little slut.
Who is she calling a slut?
Shh. I heard that. Come on, deny it. Where is she?
It was me.
Vic, stop that!
What was you?
The voice you heard. I was talking to myself. Listen, your perfume suits you. It's cheap and common.
Well, at least she slapped your side.
And who did I hear you say was fondling you in the men's room?
Me.
Liar.
How dare she?
Oh, Edwina!
Edwina! My name is Peggy, you pig!
Oh! No, let me explain. It's Edwina Cutwater. She died today.
You did it with a dead woman?
No, Roger, you are sick. To think I came up here to even discuss marrying you, despite the fact that I heard what you're doing to my mother.
How did your mother get into this?
I just found out you're going to court tomorrow to represent the other side against my own mother.
I'm representing your father.
You're going to try to beat my mother.
Oh, God.
Roger, you go to court tomorrow. We're through.
If I don't, your father will have my balls.
Then it's either me or your balls, Roger. You can't have both.
Very interesting choice. I'm not certain what purpose balls actually serve, but they've got to make a better pair than the two of you.
Well?
I'm very attached to them, Peg.
Goodbye, Roger. By the way, I never liked your dog, and I think Jazz is stupid. Faked all those orgasms. Sound familiar?
Yeah, well, I faked mine, too.
Oh, believe me, we're better off without her. She just isn't right for us. You know, ever since our little accident, I have sensed a lot of hostility coming from you.
Well, excuse me! But I'm watching my entire career go right down the sewer because I've got a dead woman living inside me. And the only person who can get you out is some cosmic weirdo you can't even find!
I can so find him, I think.
Wait, I'm sure I know where he'll be this evening. Do you have a car?
Damn it!
Chickie-wee!
What are you doing?
I never learned how to drive. What you think, one of these pedal things?
The brakes, not the gas.
Oh. The brakes, the gas. I don't know which it is.
Vic, let go of her.
Stop it! Ow! I'm gonna strangle this amazing mongrel.
All right, that's it.
This isn't the way. Where are we going?
It's enough that I ought to put up with you, but I will not subject my dog to this 1 minute more. Tyrone. Oh, great. I gotta talk to you.
Hey, Roger Dodger. I got a call from the union about some gig. They wouldn't tell me who recommended me, but I smelled your fingerprints all over it. Thank you, bro.
It was nothing, really. Can we get on with this, please?
Who's that? Someone with you?
Sort of, yeah.
Where are your manners, chump? Introduce me to the lady.
Edwina Cutwater, Tyrone Wattell. Pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you. Harry Knuckles for a chick.
Look, I need your help. Can you take care of Bix for a couple of days?
Wait a minute, Roger. What's wrong?
I really don't think I could explain it.
What's wrong, Roger?
Well, Edwina died today. Her soul entered me and took over the right half of my body.
Well, why didn't you say so in the first place?
I knew you'd understand. Thanks for not having me committed.
Roger, I got a lot of friends crazy in you, but I ain't got any better.
Thanks, pal. Go with them, Bix.
Come on, Bix. Nice meeting you, Edwina.
Bye.
Ah! woman who would rather buy a candle than curse the darkness.
Boy, you really pack them in, don't you?
Hello?
Come in. I can start
over if you'd like.
No, thank you.
And we wonder, O Lord, what it means when a person passes away and so few take the time to pay final respects.
Oh, big deal.
He's not here. Let's go find him.
However, we have received a number of mailgrams from bereaved loved ones.
Wait. I must hear this.
Lady, I have to prepare for the most important case of my life. Let's get out of here, okay?
No, I want to hear these mailgrams.
Oh, I've really got
to... I mean it, Sit.
Very touching. We will miss her. The Bel Air Oxygen Supply Company.
Oh, that's sweet.
She was truly a great customer. J&J wheelchairs.
They remembered.
And from Browning Orthopedic Mattresses, may she continue to rest in peace.
Oh, how deeply touching. Mr. Cobb.
Huh?
Mr. Cobb.
Oh, hi. What time is it?
Almost midnight. Mr. Cobb, this morning you were going to tell me how you knew it didn't work.
Oh, God. Edwina? She's asleep.
Who's asleep?
Oh, shh, Edwina, don't wake her. Wow. This is great when she's asleep.
Mr. Cobb, Miss Cutwater's dead.
No, she's not. She entered me instead of you.
What?
Where's the Swami?
I haven't seen him.
Maybe he's back at the hotel.
I just called. There's no answer.
Oh, we should go there and wait for him. I gotta find that guy. I can't take much. Oh, God.
Oh, poor dear. You must relax. Stop worrying.
Oh, no, I really think we ought to go find him.
I'm sure he'll be at the funeral tomorrow morning. And if Miss Cutwater really is inside you, he will help her. Leave your body and enter mine.
I think I envy her.
Mr. Cobb, this morning, when I placed your hand on my heart, did you feel anything special?
Yes. I felt your love.
Yes. I felt something very special. Oh, Mr. Cobb, by this time tomorrow, my soul will be gone. I want to know love one last time.
Don't you think we really ought to go?
Please, Mr. Cobb, let me take the memory of passion to sustain me in the next world.
So this would be like for a good cause?
Oh, yes.